Hello students, today's topic is introduction to Bezier curve. Now before moving on to the Bezier curve, we'll see what is curve, how curves are classified and how curves are represented. So first we'll see the curves. So curves are of two type. One is artistic curve. Artistic curve and another one is engineering curve. Engineering curve. Now, what is the difference between this artistic curve and engineering curve? Artistic curve is like a painter painting a curve on a canvas. So, the curve which is drawn by an artist on a canvas is artistic curve, whereas engineering curve is the one which follows certain mathematical formulation while drawing its trajectory. So the difference between the artistic curve and engineering curve is that the artistic curve does not follow any mathematical formulation while tracing its trajectory, whereas the engineering curve is the one who follows a mathematical formulation while drawing its trajectory. So in artistic curve, no mathematical formulation involved in it, whereas in engineering curve, mathematical formulation is involved. Okay, that means each and every point on this curve can be determined by a mathematical formula. Okay, whereas in this artistic curve there is no mathematical formula. That means the engineering curves can be represented mathematically. Okay, whereas the artistic curve doesn't follow any mathematical formulation. Now we'll see this engineering curve. Now we know that the engineering curve is the one who has got a mathematical formula. So mathematical representation are of three types. One, first is explicit form. Explicit form. Implicit form and parametric form. That means the mathematical formulation can be categorized into explicit form, implicit form and parametric form. Now we'll see what is this explicit form, implicit form and parametric representation. I'll take one example to explain the explicit form. So explicit form are those form where the value of a coordinate is explicit. Only one value is possible. Whereas in implicit form, there are multiple values are possible. If I take an example of a line. Now you may say that whether line is a curve or not. So line is a curve. So if you join these two points, so this is a line. So line is also a curve. Okay. So, and what is the mathematical representation of this line? It is y equal to mx plus c. Okay. And here the value of y, whatever may be the value of x, because in this formula y equal to mx plus c, the term m, that is slope of a line, and c, that is y-intercept of a line, is constant. So the only variable which is possible is value of x. So whatever may be the value of x, you will get only one value of y. Means if you keep on changing the value of x, every time you will get the answer, one answer for y. So that is explicit answer. Explicit means single answer. Okay, so that is called, this is an explicit form of a curve. Now implicit form. Now what is implicit form? I'll take an example circle. Now what is the mathematical equation of a circle? It is x square plus y square equal to r square. And if you rearrange this equation, it is y square equal to r square minus x square, and y is equal to under root of r square minus x square. So if you put a value of x here, because r is the radius of a circle, which is a constant one, so another variable is value of x. So if you put any value of x, it will give two answers. One is positive and another one is negative. That means there will be two values for y. That is why this form is called implicit form. This form is called implicit form. Whereas in explicit form, you will get only one value of y. Okay, hope you understand the difference between explicit and implicit form. Now next is the parametric form. Now to explain the parametric form, I will take an example of circle. But this time I will use a parametric equation of a circle. Now what is a parametric equation of a circle? Parametric equation of a circle is given by x is equal to r cos theta and y is equal to r sin theta. Okay, now this is a circle, this is x axis, this is y axis, this is any point on a circle, say x comma y. Okay, if you join this point with the center, then this inclination is theta. Okay, now if you try to calculate the value of x here, now this length is radius r, and if you try to find out the x value, is nothing but r cos theta. And if you try to find out this value, that is y value, then y is equal to r sin theta. Okay, so that is why x is given by r cos theta and y is equal to r sin theta. So this is a parametric representation of a circle where the parameter is theta. Why theta? Because to generate points on a circle for 360 degree, you have to vary the value of theta from 0 to 360. So here 0 degree is less than or equal to theta less than equal to 360 degree. Now you have to vary the value of theta from 0 degree to 360 degree to obtain the entire points on a circle. Okay, so this is a parametric representation of a circle where the varying parameter is theta. So here you can say that x is a function of theta, or fx is a function of theta, and y is a function of theta. where theta is the parameter which is changing. So that is why this is called the parametric form, parametric equation. Okay. Now these curves are of various type, two-dimensional curves or three-dimensional curves. Three-dimensional curves are also called as space curves. What is the difference between two-dimensional curve and three-dimensional curve? In two-dimensional curve, only x and y values are changing throughout the curve. Whereas in three-dimensional curve, x, y and z, all the three parameters keep on changing and it travels into the space. It doesn't constrain to a single plane. So that is why this is two-dimensional and three-dimensional curves. And one of the important curve of three-dimensional is spline. Now what is spline? Now in olden days, whenever they have to design a nose of a ship, then they use a thin wire. They use a thin wire, flexible wire, and they try to obtain the trajectory of a curve by putting a nails here. They put the nails here, put the nails here, they put the nails here, they put the nails, and they keep on tweaking the position of nails to change the trajectory. Okay. So this is from where this spline curve is, the name spline is generated. Okay. Now these nails are nothing but the control points of this curve. If you change the position of these nails, then the trajectory or behavior of a curve changes. This same concept is used by the computer graphics developers or CAD software developers, and they have generated splines into the software by using these control points. Okay, so these splines, they are categorized into two categories. One is interpolation curve or spline curve, and next is approximation curve. Now, interpolation curve and approximation curve, these are the two types of the spline. Okay. Now, what is the difference between interpolation curve and approximation curve, or what is interpolation curve and what is approximation curve? In the interpolation curve, the curve or a spline is passing through all the points which are mentioned by the designer. So this interpolation curve will pass through all the control points, which are given by the designer. Whereas in approximation curve, the curve doesn't pass through the control points, or not necessarily pass through the control points. For example, these are the four control points. Then the approximation curve will look something like this. So it will pass through this point and this point, but it will not pass through these two points. So this is called approximation curve. Approximation curve. So what is the difference between interpolation curve and approximation curve? Interpolation curve always passes through all the control points which are given by the designer, and in case of approximation curve, the curve not necessarily pass through all the control points. Okay, that is why it is called as approximation curve. Okay, so the spline is categorized into interpolation curve and approximation curve, or interpolation spline and approximation spline. Now the examples of interpolation curve and approximation curve are, the example of interpolation curve is Hermit curve. Hermit curve. Okay, these are the example. And the example of approximation curve is Bezier curve. And B spline is called as basis spline. Okay, so the example of interpolation curve is Hermit curve, and example of approximation curve is Bezier curve and B spline. So this is how we come to the introduction of Bezier curve. So Bezier curve is basically an approximation curve in the category of spline, which is a three-dimensional engineering curve. Okay, so I hope you understand what is curve, how they are classified, how they are represented, what are the different ways of representation like implicit form, explicit form, parametric form, then what is a spline, and how the spline is further categorized into interpolation curve and approximation curve. And the example of interpolation curve is Hermit curve, and approximation curve is Bezier curve and B spline. Now as far as your syllabus is concerned, we'll see the Bezier curve in very, very detail in the coming lectures. Thank you.